Hello everyone and thank you for joining us. I'm Tamir Geffen, the CEO of ALM Toolbox. Today, I'm going to have a discussion with David Cohen.
Hello everyone, thank you for having me.
David is the product manager of our new ALM Vitality product and the upcoming ALM Performance tool. He is a DevOps expert too.
We have developed a monitoring tool based on requests from many users who work with Jenkins and other configuration management tools, who wants to gain better control over the system and apply the best practices for Jenkins monitoring and DevOps. We've just released a new milestone, and it's a good time to stop and share some of our knowledge and insights with the community.
Yes, that's great. So these are the topics we are going to discuss today. First, we will talk about the reasons for monitoring critical hosts. Then, we will talk about the challenges users face when applying monitoring for the critical hosts. We will discuss which components you should monitor on Jenkins and the relevant metrics, and we also demonstrate a new tool that enables you to monitor Jenkins using these metrics. And lastly, we will have time for questions and answers. Let's begin. Let's start with understanding the reasons for monitoring.
Yes, Tamir. To better understand the situation, we have to remember that the common mission for developers, release engineers, and all the people involved and affected by the continuous integration process is to deliver a high-quality solution much faster. It is a continuous demand which comes from managers, developers, DevOps personnel, and of course from the market. And as we will see now, monitoring is one of the key instruments for achieving this goal.
Yes, thanks David. I remember when we designed ALM Vitality, we asked ourselves and our Jenkins customers for the reasons to monitor Jenkins hosts.
Yes, and they provided some great answers. So let's see them all now. Number one, make sure the Jenkins environment is performing at 100% of its ability. Number two, gain better control of the system and understand the status of each component of the host. Point number three is identifying issues in real time while they are still relatively minor and before they start having critical effect on the system. The real-time alerting can be critical for meeting delivery deadlines, making email alerting one of the key components in every monitoring tool.
Yes, and this approach is consistent with bug management. It is better to find and fix them while they are still minor and as soon as they appear in the system.
Another important reason is identify bottlenecks in your environment and processes, especially where you can measure the performance. For example, job estimated time run, server queues. These measurements allow the user to adapt or fine-tune the system in real time. Good monitoring need to be able to to direct the user to the root cause of the issue. It is especially important when you encounter an issue which affects multiple components. For example, if the web server is not responding and your web queries fail, check to see if either your web server or network are down. Next thing, the monitoring system is a single source of truth. We all know it is important to monitor IT components, but monitoring the application behavior and application health is as important as monitoring storage or network. Monitoring the system's behavior allows you to get a better understanding of the system performance in the application level. Furthermore, when you get all the important information regarding your system in one screen, you do not need to collect information from different sources and people, but you can simply start investigating the root cause. This can only be achieved with a monitoring system that is tailored for a specific product. This leads to the conclusion that excellent monitoring is the base for making important design choices like adding memory, CPU, how to load balance or fine-tune your system, etc.
Yes. Yes. Lastly, it's important to remember that monitoring is one of the DevOps best practices.
Right. I heard people call it continuous improvements as well.
Okay, David, I'm sold. I understand why it's important to monitor. Now please explain the challenges customers face when they want to implement a monitoring system.
No problem. The first challenge organizations face when thinking about implementing a monitoring tool is, what do we need to monitor? Answering that question takes a lot of understanding and expertise, both in IT and application and on the application side. This knowledge is usually spread across the organization and is not always available for the person responsible. The second challenge is time. If there is something shared by all personnel in all organization, in all of the organization, is that there is not enough time. Everyone is busy all the time, so acquiring the necessary knowledge and taking the time to design and develop the monitoring process gets harder. Everybody is dealing with their ongoing tasks.
Yes, and we see it in nearly all organizations show that only the first stage in the process, which is deciding what to monitor, can easily take 3 to 4 months, and that is without taking into consideration the internal organization politics.
That's right. Another difficulty is building the correct user interface, especially when we are talking about real-time events and notifications. For example, with ALM Vitality, we had to balance a simple dashboard with the user's demand to get specific and easy to read reports that would be helpful for resolving the issue. Another challenge is monitoring systems' ability to grow with your environments and adapt to the changes in the application. When you use scripts, it's harder to scale and monitor more components and hosts. And that brings me to the next point. Another difficulty with monitoring tools is the ability to configure the tool easily while maintaining much flexibility as possible. The monitoring tool should allow the user to monitor each host separately, send notifications only to a specific email group, and lets the user decide which components to monitor and when to monitor them.
Yes, let's continue to our last point, consolidating both IT and application data.
Gladly. Gathering and presenting both IT and application data presents a major challenge when developing a monitoring solution. Lack of sufficient knowledge is one of the challenges, together with the lack of data accessibility. For example, when the IT is managed apart from the development department. When you have the ability to see information on both IT and application, you gain a better understanding about the root cause and how it affects your system.
Thanks, David. Now let's start talking about the best practices for Jenkins. We will start with mapping Jenkins' main components. We will not cover all of them in this webinar, and we will explain what is important to monitor for each one of them.
Yes, there is a long list here. I will briefly go over it. I would just like to say that in the monitoring tool we will present in just a few minutes, we will see we are monitoring most of them. Among the components to monitor, we have the physical and virtual hosts that can function as Jenkins masters or slaves, queues for running jobs and internal Jenkins tasks, and of course the infrastructure resources like memory, CPU and storage, and the application infrastructure including the web application and the JVM.
Let's go back for a moment to the components we can measure. For these components, we not only check to see if they are working, but actually measure the performance, helping the customer determine if they are optimized, find bottlenecks, and fine-tune the system to make it more efficient.
Exactly. You can see that we measure both IT and application components. We will soon cover the components and their measures, but before we will do that, it is important to give a little bit more background for our tailored monitoring solution for Jenkins called ALM Vitality.
Okay, yes, this is the ALM Vitality dashboard.
I will explain what we see here. The dashboard shows a representation of all the servers monitored by ALM Vitality. Each row represents a monitored server. It can be ClearCase, ClearQuest, and of course Jenkins. Each column represents a monitoring test, and each cell shows the status of the test for a specific server. The tests are tailored for each server type. And the tests are both application and IT testing and can be customized to the user's environment. For example, you can define storage thresholds and get warning and error notifications as soon as your host runs out of space.
Thanks, David. Let's see the components and metrics we should track.
We will show four slides with 13 components for Jenkins master and slaves, both IT and application tests, that together provides a full coverage of your Jenkins environment. We will incorporate a demonstration of our latest development, the ALM Vitality, which monitors most of the components, and in the next version will monitor all of them. On the application side, it monitors the following for each master. Report jobs that are running longer than they should, i.e. monitoring stuck jobs. You configure which jobs to monitor, and you can set a relevant threshold for each monitoring job separately. This also helps you discover delayed jobs in your pipeline and better understand the job dependencies. When a job runs longer than configured, the ALM Vitality will send a notification to the dashboard, as you can see on the screen, and also send an email notification, as you can see now. We check to see whether the Jenkins web application is responding correctly, check if your Java virtual machine, the JVM, which serves the Jenkins application, is actually running. And when we are monitoring IT resources, we should track the following. Check if the host is alive and can be reached over the network. Test to make sure that Jenkins service is up and running. Test to make sure that all the needed ports for the web application are listening. Monitor the status of the server's available storage capacity and let you define thresholds and get notifications before you run out of space. At this point, I would like to remind you all that all the metrics we have just described are now available as a part of a latest release of ALM Vitality. If you want to download it, please send an email to apm@almtoolbox.com or just reply to the webinar invitation. And we will send you instructions on how to download and install it, so you can start enjoying this monitoring tool very soon. This is a full version with all functionality inside. If you would like to get details about pricing, please mention it in the email and send it to us. Okay, now let's move to more metrics we need to monitor. So on the application side, we need to monitor masters and slave connectivity, monitor the amount of online executors, i.e. alerts if total executors is below a specific threshold, monitor queue lengths, for example, alert if a queue has more than 28 jobs for more than 10 minutes. Add job dependencies information when you get alerts for stuck jobs. And on the IT resources side, monitor consumed memory, for example, more than 80% usage for more than 5 consecutive minutes. Monitor consumed CPU, for example, more than 70% usage for more than 10 consecutive minutes. And of course, both parameters are configurable by the user.
Thanks you, David. That's very useful. We are nearing the end of the webcast. Let's summarize it. We explained why it's important to monitor critical systems. We talked about the challenges of monitoring. We talked about the important components and metrics to monitor in Jenkins. And we introduced a new system that monitors it all and resolves all mentioned challenges. Now it's time for questions and answers. Let me check if we have some questions. Please hold on for 1 second. Okay, David, I see we have two questions. Are you ready?
Of course.
Okay, the first one is, why should I use ALM Vitality and not one of the other monitoring tools out of the market that allows me to monitor service and environments?
Okay, so the ALM Vitality was tailored specifically to monitor Jenkins, ClearCase, and ClearQuest environments and provide full monitoring coverage. When you install one of the other monitoring tools, you still need to decide which components to monitor, define and write all the elements for the monitoring process tests. Users of these tools told us that it usually takes about 6 months to 1 year to complete the process. With ALM Vitality, we already did all of that work for you, and you get a system that starts monitoring and showing status in 1 hour.
Yes, we actually put all of our knowledge into this tool, and you just enjoy it. Okay, thanks, David. The second question is, will the ALM Vitality support other tools in the future?
Definitely. As we mentioned, we developed a framework which allows us to expand and adjust the ALM Vitality to monitor other tools. If you have a critical system in your ALM process that you wish to monitor in the same way we just presented, please contact us via email at apm@almtoolbox.com or contact me directly at davido@almtoolbox.com and state the name of the system, and we will answer if and when it will be done.
Thank you, David, and thank you all for joining us. If you have any questions in future, do not hesitate to contact us at apm@almtoolbox.com. To learn more, you can visit the website, our website, at almtoolbox.com/jenkins-monitoring. I hope you learned new things and enjoyed. Thank you again, and have a nice day.